Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to the Connecticut Bowling Operator Association's Duck Pin Challenge. I'm Joe Schwager. My colleague today is Bruce Sylvester. We're here at the T-Bowl in Newington to bring you some more exciting action in some of the top duck pin bowlers in the game. Today in our third match, Rich Dunnick of Mansfield takes on Tom Tedesco of Waterbury, and the winner of that match will go on to face our current reigning champion, Miles Kincannon from Torrington. And we'll be back with that first exciting match right after this message. Welcome once again to the Duck Pin Challenge, a word of scoring in the duck pin game. Scoring in duck pins consists of 10 frames of strikes, spares, and open frames. A strike is when you clear all 10 pins from the lanes with your first ball. Scoring symbol is an X. 10 pins are added to the frame you are in, plus the score on the next two balls that you roll. A spare is when you clear all 10 pins from the lane with two balls thrown. You add 10 to that frame, and then the score of your next ball that you roll in that game is then added to the score. An open frame is the number of pins you have cleared from the lane with three balls, and it is possible in the duck pin game throwing three balls to have a score of 10 in one frame. And now, Bruce, how about our bowlers this afternoon?
At our first match this afternoon, we have Rich Dunnick from Mansfield, Connecticut, current league average of 143. And facing him will be Tom Tedesco from Waterbury, Connecticut. His current average is 142. And the winner of that match will face our current champion, Miles Kincannon from Torrington, Connecticut, carrying a 149 average.
Miles Kincannon looking to defend his crown today, but for right now, bowling for the right to face Miles for the $400 top prize in today's contest, Rich Dunnick, Tom Tedesco. Rich Dunnick leading off from Mansfield.
Rich threw a good first ball there, left up the 5-7 split. Notice the high backswing.
High single game for Rick of 210. Three game series high of 547. Tall, slim right-hander. Backup ball from the right-hand side of the lane. And actually hit that one too good. Too light on the 5 pin, bringing it in front of the 7.
He glared down at that pin. Threw it across the lane, just a little bit too thin.
Dunnick looking for a 10. And there it is. And his opponent up for the first time in this match is Tommy Tedesco from Waterbury. Tom's high single game, 224. Nice single game there in a three-game series of 536.
What a break Tom got with his first pitch.
Little timber on the six pin there. Ball extremely high coming in here. Watch the action off the left-hand side. That was the two pin. Normally the head pin comes back across, but very tight on that hit. Two pin all the way back across to take out the six. Similar deliveries between these two bowlers. Bruce?
Both smooth bowlers. Let the ball do the damage. Tommy's a little nervous up there. I see him taking a deep breath just before he threw that first ball. Ripped the middle out. He's trying to cover as much wood as he can. He's on a strike. Just pins that up. He had a great shot. Eight on the strike. He's got 18 in the first.
Very nice try coming into the left-hand side of the three pin. Both bowlers back up spin, coming in from the right-hand side. Tommy's a little closer to the center of the lane at the line than Rich is. Yeah, a little bounce back there.
Made the comeback shot for a 10. 28 in the second.
One of those sweet features of duck pins. Fly back action.
Rich qualified for the show shooting 741 for five games. And it's a good goal. And he was leading it on Saturday. And on Sunday, three guys went by him. High backswing. Almost left another split with the same ball. This is to convert the seven pin first pair.
This is the pin he made for a 10 in the first frame. I'd like to cover it right here. And does so nicely. So 20 plus the next ball that he throws. He's down by eight.
Rich bowls out of the lucky strike bowling alley. He's a romantic. He's also the manager there. I'm sure he gets a lot of extra practice in. Missed the head pin. Left up the 1-3 for a spare. Have to clear that deadwood.
Bruce, I gotta wonder if as I look here and watch Rick Dunnick with the his highest league average ever of 143. I gotta wonder if Rich has a shirt to go with every set of bowling balls or vice versa here. We're talking coordination. And there's coordination into the spare for 38 plus in the third. We got a tie ball game, and we're going to take it from that third frame when we come back right after we show you these.
If you're in the Torrington area and like to bowl some duck pins, try Arcade Lanes on Main Street. In the Watertown area, Blue Ribbon Lanes on Main Street in Watertown. In the Cheshire area, Cheshire Lanes, Milldale Road in Cheshire.
And the adults can take the kids along with them, or the kids can take the adults along with them. Everybody can play this game. Tommy Tedesco, tie ball game, 28-2. Dunnick with a spare up in the third. Looking for the first strike of the match. Right into the 1-2, leaving himself with the 6 for the 3, 5, and 10. Tommy was the winner in the Bristol A tournament and the Meriden A tournament.
Hit a great shot there, Lee. Making it a 3, 5, and 10. The 3-pin into the wall and into the 10-pin.
Ball doing work on the front 2 pins, firing the 3-pin back to take out the 10. And we're still neck and neck.
Dead even match here. Tommy's on a spare in the third frame.
Fourth frame for Tom.
Bounce that ball. Got a break there. Broke up the 7-8.
There was some interesting action on those pins. Pins coming. Watch the head pin right here. Head pin bounced around and actually was bumped back into the wall in order to carry the 7. Little body tackle there on the head pin.
Rich is working on a spare right now. That ball got away from him a little bit.
A little quick, pin spinning.
Got a 6 load, 44 in the third.
Unusual formation for this location on the lane here. We're looking at the 2, 5, 8, and 9. Wants to hit it tight, just a little bit to the left of that 2 pin.
That was a tough pin, the 8 pin. You have to get lucky, have the pin come off the wall. He is smooth.
And a 10 and 54 through 4. He's down by 4 pins. Plus the strike count for Tommy Tedesco. Rich Dunnick, Waterbury. Mansfield.
All 10 went down with that ball. Good extension into the 1-2 pocket.
Ball turning right back in. Heavy. 9 pins disappeared, and one just stuck around to let everybody know they were used to be there.
Tommy's up in the fourth frame. He's four pins ahead. He's out working on a strike. Could be a double.
There it is. Two strikes in a row. Now this one again, coming into that 1-2 pocket, ball turning backwards. Almost a replay of Rich Dunning's strike now. Situation is this, Tommy Tedesco with a doubleheader strike. Should he throw the third one, we'll receive a $50 bonus from the CBOA. $50 ball here.
One more, here's the triple.
We're seeing some action on these guys in this match, Bruce. Again, extremely high on the hit. And this ball crossed when he didn't want it to, and pins just sliding around, seeking out their own kind, and a triple header strike was worth a $50 bonus for Tommy Tedesco.
That puts him in the driver's seat right now. Rich has to come back with a double of his own. Ball just slid away on him. Moved to the right side of the alley. He's left a real tough split here. 4, 7, 8, and 10.
Two ways to go on this shot. It's got to be light, inside or outside. Bring the 4-pin off the wall, play the 4-pin off of the 7.
Had a good try at that spare. 8 load on the strike in the fifth box. He's at 72.
At this point in time, with 80 through the sixth, we've got Rich down by 28 pins, plus a couple of counts. So he's definitely got a.
This is a key frame right here for Rich. He has to get it going here. So another good ball, and let's lift the spin up there. He's not catching any breaks.
Head pin came off the wall that time and took off, actually leaped over the 5-10.
Brought it back in the lane. Just missed the 10 pin.
That hurts. When you get that power in there to bring that pin back, you really hope it does some damage. There's a 10 and a score of 90 for Rich Dunnick. And 108 with a doubleheader up through six for Tom Tedesco. And we'll be back for the conclusion of this match right after this. And we're back at the Duck Pin Challenge. And a little Duck Pin trivia. What's the highest score a bowler can roll without a mark in Duck Pins? We're paying attention to our explanation of scoring earlier. Maybe able to put 2 and 2 or at least 10 and 10 together and come up with an answer for that. And right now we've got Tommy Tedesco of Waterbury coming up in the 7th frame. He's already thrown a triple header for a $50 bonus. Every strike Tommy should add to this string would be an additional $50.
Tommy's pushing this one out now. Good extension. Could be.
Again, full.
The pin is spinning around. Just didn't knock it down. Still got a spare break, shooting at the 3-6. That's going to increase his lead. Right now, he's 34 pins ahead, plus this next ball. Covered that spare just like it's supposed to.
126 through the 6th for Tom Tedesco, a spare up in the 7th. Right now,
46 pin lead. Plus this ball.
Tough position to be in for Rich when you're down in the match like this and you can't do anything but sit there and watch your opponent right now.
What a ball. Even bouncing the ball, he's getting the action.
Ball coming up again, just like Tommy's earlier strikes, into the 1-2, and good mix across the lane. Really nice game going, 156 with the strike up in the 8th.
Rich is really pressing here. He just can't get anything going. He almost had the 5-7 again. Throwing a good ball, it's out on the lane. Good extension, good follow through. He's just not driving the 5-pin out.
He's not getting the pin action he needs. Really had some rough luck with the pins coming off the side.
Covered the seventh pin for a spare.
100 plus in the eighth. Down by 56.
Oh, for a one game match, he's not throwing a bad game. It's just that his opponent get hot real quick. Put the ball in there full, had a split. Piece of wood come around, kicked out the odd pin for him, so he's shooting at a two pinner. 3-6. But he spares don't help in this position. Not enough frames left for him.
And picking off the front pin.
When things go bad, they just go bad.
Well, here's the situation with that 9, 117 for Rich Dunnick. Still showing nice follow through, nothing wrong with the form. He's just had some bad break of pins coming off the wall on the first ball. 117, best Rich can do is 147. Tommy right now with 156 plus.
Tommy throws him up here.
There's a strike.
Tommy wants another $50.
Another double. We're looking at it.
Ball this time, unlike his earlier strikes, crossing over the head pin. Good wash over to the right hand side.
We've got a possibility of a 200 game here, Joe.
Strike right here. It's worth another $50.
Ball's a little bit light. It bounced. Kick to the right. A bad fill.
It's not going to happen in this match, Bruce, but no. If any of our bowlers during the course of the show should throw an all-mark game, they'd receive a $200 bonus.
If he makes this mark, he can still throw 200. He's picked off one, and he's got 183 in the ninth.
And a 191 game for Tommy Tedesco. Beautiful game.
It's a great game he just bowled.
191. We can't forget that major league bonus. We also have Bruce, of any bowler, male or female, should break the current existing single game world record. $10,000 bonus to him.
There was nothing wrong with that ball, and he had a split standing up there again. The 10 pin finally fell for him. It just wasn't Rich's day. He threw the ball well. Had it off the lane, hit the pocket, hit his object pins all day long. Just couldn't get the breaks he needed. Made the spare in the 10th. Rich have 127 plus one ball.
See a game in the 130s here, and unfortunately, gentlemen, not even close.
There's the one he wanted.
Beautiful finish. 137 for Richard Dunnick. But that doesn't make it against a 191 from Tommy Tedesco. And we'll be back with our championship match after these messages.
If you're in the Middletown area, you want to bowl duck pins, Gilletti's Bowling Room on Main Street. In the Plainfield area, Highway Lanes, Route 12, Plainfield. And if you're in the Manchester area, Holiday Lanes on Spencer Street in Manchester, Connecticut.
And this is Joe Schweiger along with Bruce Sylvester back here at the T-Bowl Lanes in Newington for our championship match this week. Tommy Tedesco, who just barreled a 191 game against Rich Dunnick, now to meet our current reigning champion, Miles Kincannon of Torrington. Miles got to be thinking about that display that Tommy just put on.
That might work in his favor. Probably thinking that Tommy just threw the big game. He's not going to throw another one at him. Miles come out of the shoot with a strike.
Ball going in heavy. Miles got a little bit of a spin on that backspin, but he got all the break there. Domino effect, 10 into 6 into the 3.
Let's see if Tommy can keep this going now. A great first game.
Right on the line.
Ball right there. Left with the 6 pin for a spare.
And sneaking in behind the 6. Two bowlers here, both bowlers been hot in recent days, and we could be seeing one heck of a match here. A spare in the first frame for Tommy Tedesco.
We're all even here after one.
Tommy Tedesco is the winner of the Torrington A tournament and also champion in the Danbury mixed doubles.
That pin snapped across the lane. Just missed the 4-7. Shoot that a spare break. Two pinner. I asked Tommy earlier and I asked him, do you pin bowl or spot bowl? He's definitely a pin bowler. Staring right down the pins. I think that's the first mark Tommy missed. Well, he's throwing all strikes anyway, so. 5 of his marks in the last game were strikes.
Do what you had to do with them too, put them together. 28 through 2 for Tommy Tedesco. Winner of this match, $400. Loser, $200. Winner returns in 2 weeks to defend his championship. Miles Kincannon has bowled 48 200 games.
He almost came back with a double. Gee, that pin spinning around. Just had to hit the 6 pin lightly, knock it at the 3 pin. But it had a double strike and it looked like it was an instant replay.
And a spare in the second for Miles Kincannon. Okay, Bruce, now look, I gave you plenty of time. How about that trivia answer? What's the highest score you can get in the duck pin game without a mark?
They make all 10s in duck pins for 100.
And that's a very, very difficult feat to do. And Miles Kincannon with that spare up, 30 plus. Tommy Tedesco, 28 in the second. 2-pin lead plus this ball.
Another full hit. Had the pin scattered. Left up the 2-pin, I think. Left with the 4-pin. Shooting the 4 for a spare. That 9 low gives him an 11-pin lead. Right on target.
And a spare up out of the gate. Strike, spare, spare. Miles Kincannon, good concentration. Wrist turning over right at the end. He caught a little bit of spin on that ball. And he's got the spare up in the third. Strike, spare, spare. And we're going to be back in our championship match right after we bring you this. to go with Tommy Tedesco in the third frame, down by 11. Miles Kincannon, defending champion, with a spare up. If you weren't with us earlier, Tommy Tedesco defeated Rich Dunnick soundly with a 191 game. Beautiful game for Tommy.
This is where Tommy started striking in the first match. Exactly the same score. Didn't quite get a strike. As a single to shoot at, shooting the seventh pin.
Tommy was the winner of the Holiday mixed doubles and also Senna's mixed doubles event.
Ball just slipped off into the channel on him. I know he wanted to make that one.
Ten for Tommy in the third frame, 38. He's still down by 11. Miles has a count ball to go. Miles is 3/10 of the way there to that all-mark game and a $200 bonus.
Ball just went through the middle, left the 2-4-3-6. Looked like he pushed that one out a little bit.
Tommy's probably thinking, I don't care if Miles gets those 10 marks and a $200 bonus. Let me start getting my strikes together so I can still beat him. Nice try.
Try to give it a cut shot. Slide the three pin into the two, which topple into the four. Now he's just trying to hold the wood. That's the name of his game. Knock down as many pins as you can.
And nine for Tommy Tedesco, and 47 in the fourth. Bruce, tell me, what's Miles' hobby? What's he list as a hobby there?
He lists the stamp collecting as his hobby. That's interesting.
Well, what I want to know is, does his employer know about that?
United States Postal Service, I wonder.
I'm hoping he's only collecting the ones he's paying for. Ball turned out. 3,500 sets for Miles Kincannon to go along with those 48 200 games. And that ball just wouldn't split out off the head pin for him. Heavy. Made a nice try. He was looking at the 3, 4, 7, and 10.
Notice Miles lifted that ball out a little further than the other ones.
And a 10, 65, 18 pin lead.
Miles is thinking about that last ball he threw. He thought he had it right where he wanted to, and the ball just straightened out. Ripped the middle out on him. Miles cleans that first ball all the time. And then you notice his thumb goes to his mouth, but then he wipes it off in his pants. Good follow through there. Pin's dancing around.
Actually, not what he was hoping for off the right-hand side on this ball. Watch the head pin. Ducked actually behind the six to take out the 10.
Lifted that right out, make that spare. Arm extended straight at the pin. Tommy Tedesco's in a little trouble here. He's down 18 pins, and he's open.
Let's get that strike ball working.
Is one. Cleared out 10 pins off the lane. Perfect pitch. Perfect ball in the 1-3 pocket. Drove all 10 pins out. Each pin had an assignment. And they all carried it through.
Still down by 18. Now Tommy has yet to throw a bare strike today. Three together, two together. Let's see if he can keep that trend going.
Here it is. There it is. You called it, Joe. Double strike.
Put them together where they can do the most damage. Now, this ball was extremely high. This was probably the luckiest strike that we've seen today. Ball had enough speed on it to keep pins moving. Eventually bullied the sixth pin onto the plate. Now Miles has to answer, and he does.
Miles answered the call on that one. Ball was lifted right out in the lane, 1-2 pocket. All 10 pins went flying. Miles had to throw a mark there. The double strike up for Tommy Tedesco put a little pressure on him.
Still got about a 10-pin lead. Definitely needed that mark up there. Waiting for that strike ball to come back.
Well, Miles must be throwing a good ball all year long. He's carrying 148 average in two leagues. So he's not a stranger to throwing 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 marks a game. Ball just slipped away. What a good break. Pin came off the wall, knocked down the head pin. He's got the 10 pin to shoot for a single for a spare. Take advantage of those great breaks you get.
He's for the spare and he makes it. At 6 marks in 7 frames. And we're going to be back with the exciting conclusion of our championship match right after these messages.
If you're in the Hamden area and you want to bowl some duck pin, try Johnson Lanes on Dixwell Avenue. In the Winsted area, Laurel Lanes on Main Street in Winsted. And if you're in the Willimantic area, Lucky Strike Lanes on Route 32 in Willimantic.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's an idea for you. Some Saturday afternoon, one of the kids has a birthday coming up. It's a great place to have a birthday party for your child and a lot of their friends. Lots of fun. Tommy Tedesco. Working on a double. We picked up a $50 bonus for a triple in the first game today. Strike here is worth another $50.
Made that ball down. Spinning. Got a spinning wood. They're all cheering for that pin to fall. So is Tommy. Shooting the 5 pin. Makes this spear. We got a close match now.
And there he is, 96th in the sixth for Tommy Tedesco, 105 in the sixth for Miles Concannon, 9 pins separating them.
Those both, doubles add up quick.
Both the spares.
Charlie just wants to keep on throwing that good ball. Down the middle, let the ball do the work. Another good break.
Oops. This is called an oops strike.
I don't know where those pins came from, but they all had something to do.
Could have been a disaster.
Could have been a disaster, and it could have been a four-timer. That 5 pin he left in the 7th frame It's a big pin. Not only for score, but for the bonus.
Miles can't afford to let this one get away from him.
Miles lifted that ball way out on the lanes. Nine pin drop. He's shooting a seven pin for a spare.
Now that pin that was spinning for Miles there, if that pin were to have fallen off the right hand side into the channel and hit the wall as hard as it was spinning and kicked all the way back over, yeah, that would have counted for the strike. And right now, still holding on to that eight pin lead is Miles Hincannon. He's got a spare up, a strike up from Tommy Tedesco.
Miles knows one thing, he has to keep on marking because Tommy is dangerous with those double strikes.
To the opposite side, into the one-two, and the strike. Watch the head pin, does its work, off, bang, hello five pin. 144 through eight, 154 plus in the ninth, Tommy Tedesco, 126 plus in the eighth.
We got a real tight match here, some big scores. Tommy threw them on a little extra.
Here's a double. Still without a bear strike. He's got something on this ball, I tell you. Again, high hit. He's looking at a three-pin split. He was looking at the two, the four, and the sixth. Next thing you know, all the pins were gone. And we got a virtual tie game here, Bruce.
What an excellent match this one is. Again, I hate to refer to it again, but that five-pin he left up in the seventh frame, that cost him a five strike in a row. That's the first bad ball he's thrown. He's still got a seven load. A tough shot to make, though. He's trying to make the 2, 7, and 8.
Now, again, that score on the double. 10 for the first strike, 10 for the second strike, 7 for that ball right there, added up 27 in the eighth. And that eighth frame score, 144, 143, Miles still on top. Tommy's trying to touch. He needed the wood there. Needed to gather some pins.
That was an important ball he just threw there. He just missed everything. And a 7 fill gives him 160 in the ninth. Fine, 168, but that might not be enough.
Well, Miles with 154 plus with that strike up in the ninth. If he can knock down 8 pins on the first two balls, that'll be enough.
I think Miles is trying to keep away from his grip in the middle. Lifted that ball up.
And there's 8. And that's going to be enough to retain his championship. But what about those scores from Tommy Tedesco to the game? 191, 168.
Threw a great game here. Mine just was a little bit better.
Look out now, look out.
I think Miles just said to himself, thank you very much. I didn't need that one. He's going to shoot a game in the 170s.
What an exciting game this was. 173 for Miles Hincannon to defend his championship against Tommy Tedesco. And we're going to be back with the spare challenge right after we show you this. And welcome back to T-Bow Lanes in Newington, the Connecticut Bowling Operator Association's Duck Pin Challenge, and we had some exciting matches today. Miles Kincannon again defending his crown as the King of the Hill here. And a couple great games from Tommy Tedesco, 168-191. And the way these bowlers are bowling, we might give some extra money away right here. What we're going to do here is called the Spare Challenge. Right now we're working on the 5, 7, and 10, and each bowler will have a shot at making this difficult spare. Our pot is up to $325. If anyone should make it, they'll collect the money. If not, we add $25 to the pot. Come back next week and let the ladies have another try at it. So right now, let's wish the bowlers luck and hope to give some money away.
First up will be Miles Kincannon trying to make the 5-7-10. That game he just threw, he's liable to make this one. He missed a five pin on the left. Next up will be Tommy Tedesco. Tommy's just trying to tip that five over. Hit a little bit too full. And Rich Dunnick. Great shot! Just left the seven pin up. That would have been worth 325. That would have made his day interesting.
No winner again today, but another close try by Rich Dunnett. We thought we were going to give it away that time. We're going to add $25 to the pot, and next week our ladies will be shooting the 5, 7, and 10 spare break for $350. Right now I'd like to bring out my colleague, Bruce Sylvester. Bruce, you got some scores to recap today.
I have to look at them, they're so high. The first match, Rich Dunnick threw a fine 137. Tom Tedesco was on fire, had a triple and a double in the same game, shot 191. In the final match, Miles Kincannon, the defending champion, had a 173 game, and Tom Tedesco shot another 168. Some great bowling. Tom had two doubles in that game, and he had a chance. He threw a double strike, had a five-pin stand-up on him, then come back with another double. That was the difference in the whole game.
Two doubles in that game, a double and a triple in the first game. And right now, I'd like to bring out the president of the Connecticut Bowling Operator Association, Dick Bisson. Performed a little bit of magic here today.
They certainly did. This last match was one of the finest I've ever seen. And specifically with Tommy, it was very reminiscent of a game I saw him throw in the Masters this year down in Baltimore.
Excellent bowling. Some big strikes all across the lanes, and right now we've got some checks to give away to our three bowlers. First, we'd like to bring out our third place finisher from Mansfield, $120 for Rich Dunnick. Second place finisher, two big games, 168, 191, $200, Tommy Tedesco from Waterbury. You refused to throw a bare strike today, didn't you?
Yeah, they were mixing up pretty good for me today.
Double and triple in the first game, two doubles in the second.
Yeah, I don't know. Some days you catch them, some days you don't, you know.
What'd this guy do to you the second game?
I'll say he's tough. He's too tough. He just didn't give me a break, didn't give me an opening.
Well, you gave yourself plenty of breaks today, and we're going to see you in the near future.
I hope so.
All right, thanks a lot, Tom.
Thank you.
And now, we have a $400 check waiting here. Incidentally, let me mention something before I forget. Because of that triple header for Tommy Tedesco, we pick up a $50 bonus for Tommy. That'll be coming your way. Our first place finisher, $400, defending champion Miles Kincannon. How'd you stop this guy?
I just couldn't afford an open box. And he didn't throw a triple this game. It's the only thing that saved me.
Well, you also came to be one of the closest bowlers we've had to that all-mark game since the show's been on the air, and that would have been worth another $200. But you're going to be back in a couple weeks and take another shot at that.
Got a shot at that, yeah. If I get it rolling, I'll get it.
Let me ask you this now. Your wife Debbie was on with us earlier in the series, and now you're 2 weeks into your victories, defending your championship. You rubbing this in a little bit at home?
Nah, because she'll come right back and she'll give it to me. She's won the national doubles title and I never won anything nationally, so.
Is Debbie here today with you?
Yeah, she's here with the two kids. They're my good luck charms, two kids.
How much of a share of this are they going to get?
Oh, they'll get a good share. Refrigerator, maybe.
What had to be going through your mind watching that first game and seeing Tommy just whipping those strikes on Rich, and then all of a sudden he put two together against you? Did you feel like the bottom was about to drop out?
Yeah, I really did, because Tommy, I bowl with him on Friday nights, and he throws a lot of strikes. So I was just praying he didn't throw three.
Well, both of you guys were getting the action on the lanes down there. The you feel that you're a strike bowler, as this game is turning out to be, or still the spare shooter that people know is the key part of this duck pin game?
No, I still think I'm a spare shooter, because I can throw 160, 170 games like I did without throwing doubles. If you pick up your spares, enough of them add up to 160, 170.
All right, and we're going to be back in just 2 weeks with the men. Next week we'll be back with the ladies, and Ann Satage will be defending her crown. And we're going to see Dick Bisson, and also for my colleague Bruce Sylvester and myself, Joe Schwager. We hope to see you next time with more of the Connecticut Bowling Operator Association's Duckpin Challenge. So long, everybody.